Hey guys, it's Melanie. Okay, so today I am giving you my Sephora VIB sale recommendations. This list is ridiculous. It's ridiculous, I'm not gonna lie. I have a lot of things that I would like to recommend to you guys if you are in the market for any of these things or if you have ever looked at them and wondered, are they really worth it? So these are the things that I am here to say. Yes, they are 100% worth it. A lot of these things are kind of exclusively available at Sephora, but if Ulta does come out with a 20% coupon, for example, around the same time, like you could buy this Alterna stuff at Ulta. Like, I wouldn't recommend buying this at Sephora if you are only going to be getting 15% off when you can potentially get 20% at Ulta, if that makes sense. But some of these other things, you know, while available at places like Beautylish or Muse or Dermstore, unless those other places are also having a sale at the same time, you know, obviously if the sale's better there, grab them there. But you know, like Drunk Elephant, you know, obviously Sephora is one of the few retailers that does carry it, although I do think Dermstore does as well, or maybe they don't anymore. I'll need to look into that. But you get what I'm trying to say here. If you can find this stuff at another sale where it's 20% off, get it there. But if you are in the market and you need it and you're good with the 15% off, here are my thoughts on these products. I will link them all down below. Because there are so many, I am just going to give you guys a very brief, like, synopsis of why I think these are worth it or why they have been worth it to me to spend my money on. And maybe that helps you make a decision. You know, maybe it's just one review based on, you know, like a number that you're watching to try to come to a decision. Basically, I'm trying to be helpful. Hopefully it comes across as helpful because that is my intention. I will link everything down below so you can read up more about it. And yeah, so let's get into it. These are all kind of random, but I'm going to start with the Drunk Elephant Ape Passione Retinol Cream. I love it, you guys. You know that I have loved it for quite some time now. And I've been using it consistently and I really have noticed some great results with my skin. Is it as strong as like a tretinoin cream that you would get from your dermatologist? No. But I feel like it's a really good over-the-counter option that for me has definitely been a lot more effective than some of the other like over-the-counter retinols that I've used in the past. Not that those still aren't good, but this kind of took it to the next level, if that makes sense. So this A plus, I love this. I highly recommend it. Also from Drunk Elephant, you know, just because, God, don't buy this stuff at full price. It is crazy overpriced. I will 100%, like, I will own that. I think their prices are crazy. I'm sure that they could come down and still make some pretty good profits on some of this stuff. But the TLC Framboose Glycolic Night Serum, it is definitely one of my favorite glycolic night serums. It does have some BHA in it as well, which is nice. You know, obviously you can get similar products from Paula's Choice that are less expensive, and you've heard me talk about those. There are similar products that you can get from, for example, the Pharmacy Honeymoon Glow. That's another one that I would recommend, but you know, definitely it has a much lower price point, but very similar type of formulation in terms of what it's going to do for your skin, which is going to help with surface cell turnover. It's going to help your skin look brighter, more refreshed, just, you know, fresh, younger looking skin because you're exfoliating all of the gunk off that tends to accumulate and kind of get glued to your skin. So, love, love, love this. Have definitely purchased it multiple times myself. All right, Wander Beauty Baggage Claim Gold Eye Masks. You guys have heard me rave about these a number of times. They're just wonderful, they're great. And they just make your under eyes look very refreshed. And I find that the effects of these last a couple of days. You know, obviously use your eye cream in between, But I think, you know, when you can get this on sale, you should get it on sale because it's good. In terms of powder foundation recommendations that are, you know, available at Sephora, obviously, if Laura Geller was at Sephora, I would say get Bell and Brighton, but she is not. So the Wander Beauty Wanderlust Powder Foundation is wonderful. I actually use the shade medium from them, which some people are surprised by because normally I go for like fair. But I feel like their coloring is just a little bit off with that. So for me, typically being a like yellow based fair, oh my God, what is my dog doing? Hey, no. Stop it. All three of my pets are in my office with me right now, so I feel like, hey, Penny, stop it. I feel like I'm in the middle of a zoo right now. Sorry. But yeah, I feel like their coloring's a little bit off, and for me, with my yellow undertoned skin that is pretty light, pretty fair, the medium normally works. This here is a golden medium. That would be way too dark for me. All right. Sol de Janeiro Brazilian Boom Boom Cream. Always a favorite. Always gonna recommend it. I think it's beautiful. I love the way it looks on my skin. I love the way it hydrates my skin, and I love the way it smells. Smells so good. Speaking of smells, I have just a few perfume recommendations. Some of my personal favorites are Nest Indigo, Nest Midnight Fleur, and Stella McCartney Stella, which, yes, that is actually why my daughter is named Stella. Couple reasons. I love this perfume, and it was the perfume that I was absolutely in love with and still am around the time that I got pregnant with Stella. And then also, one of Craig's favorites beer is Stella Artois. So that's how we came up with the name for our kid. So there you go. Anyway, it's delightful. Obviously, you don't have to get like the biggest size for $97, but if you've never smelled it, oh, it's so pretty, you guys. It's lovely. Another brand to check out for cruelty-free is Comptoir Sud Pacifique. Their Vanille Extreme, the Vanille Apricot, and the Vanille Blackberry, absolutely delightful. I will link those down below as well. So, and also in the smell department, Nest candles, a few of them are sold at Sephora. I really love the Sicilian Tangerine, especially for the season that is coming up here, which is spring and summer. This is so refreshing, so delicious, so authentic. It's beautiful. Pick this up if you've never tried it. It is so pretty. All right, eyeshadows from Viseart. You guys know that I love these eyeshadows. I love them, you guys, and I will never apologize for that. It took me a long time to splurge on them, and as soon as I finally did, I was like, gosh, why did I wait so long? I should have just bought them in the first place, because I don't think that I would have wasted a lot of my money on some of the other eyeshadow palettes that I've bought. Just so incredibly lovely. Okay, so obviously there are the Theory palettes. I have a good chunk of these. I think they're fantastic. They're kind of a good starting off point because you're getting six full-sized eyeshadows for $45. Kind of the best deal per shadow is the Viseart Grand Pro Volume 1. You guys know this is one of my holy grail eyeshadow palettes. Yeah, it's $150. This is not going to be at everybody's price point. But it is a good deal per eyeshadow, if that makes sense. So, if you can spring it, get it on sale here and save a little bit. It's so good. I crave this almost every single day when I'm doing my makeup. It's incredible. Lastly, one of their newest releases, the Viseart Liaison Palette, is absolutely beautiful. I cannot give enough raves to this particular eyeshadow palette if you love purples. Just if you have any kind of like draw to this, personal draw where you're like, oh, it's so pretty. I can tell you that the formulation of the eyeshadows is like top notch. Love it. Let's talk some hair stuff. I could have a million recommendations here, but I kept it to just a few here. So the Verb Ghost Oil Hairspray Set is fantastic because I love this hairspray, and I love the moringa oil. And you might be like, oh shoot, what happened here? You might be like, there's no way that you use an oil in your hair, Melanie. And I will say, yes, I do, because this one works. It totally works. Yeah, give it a go. And they're both full-size products. They're $24. They're a good deal. And then also the Verb Ghost Oil Shampoo and Conditioner, this duo kit. They are the full-size products. It's a $40 value for $28. Basically, it's like getting one of them, quote-unquote, free. Just try this if you haven't. It's great lightweight hydration for the hair. Love it. You guys know that I have loved the Alterna Caviar Anti-Aging Replenishing Moisture Shampoo and Conditioner for a long time. It's a spendy one. These are obviously the larger sizes. You can also get the 8-ounce sizes, which are, you know, not going to be $52 each. But I know that I go through this stuff. So when I purchase this, I no longer purchase like the 8-ounce sizes. That's just a waste of my time. I would rather get a better deal on these larger sizes. I love this stuff. It's so concentrated. You don't need a ton of it. So don't necessarily be scared off by this price point. Feel like you just need to try it. It's so good. I love it. All right, sculpting powder recommendation. I love the Kevin Aucoin sculpting powder in medium. Took me a long time to try this because again, it's $44. And honestly, it looks like a really small container because it's small. But I have put a decent dip in mine and I still have not hit pan. And I have used this for months as my sculpting powder exclusively every single day. And I have not hit pan. Get this if you've always wanted it. It is worth it. Marc Jacobs, the Omega Gel Powder Eyeshadows, these singles. I have five or six of them. They're amazing, you guys. Amazing. Go read the reviews about them. I am not exaggerating. They just go on your eyes like butter. They're amazing. There is only one of these blushes that I own of the Marc Jacobs Air Blush Glow Duos, but you've heard me talk about it multiple times, Flesh and Fantasy. It's so pretty. If you have my coloring at all and you're looking for kind of a really pretty, just like mauve-y glow to your cheeks, you have to try it. It's so pretty. Another recent eyeshadow purchase for me from Sephora was this Marc Jacobs Iconic Stiletto Multi-Finish Eyeshadow Palette. Oh God, I think my puppy just pooped. Okay, well, I'll have to deal with that later. So I just recently purchased this and I love it. I absolutely adore it. And I think that a lot of you who are looking for a cool toned eyeshadow palette should check this one out as well. It's more expensive than a Too Faced or Tarte eyeshadow palette, but I can tell you the quality of these is hands down better than either of those two options. In terms of lipsticks, I love me some Marc Jacobs La Marc lip creme lipsticks. These are not like the latest and greatest anymore, but I think they're a great long-lasting lipstick. They are not drying, but they have a nice kind of matte finish that wears a lot longer than other typical like matte cream finish lipsticks. And I don't think the price point is awful on these for the quality and the color selection that they have. They have some really good colors available. All right, mascaras, two favorites from Sephora I'm going to recommend to you. The Marc Jacobs Velvet Noir, I mean, I've talked this to death on my channel. There's no need to elaborate here. And the Hourglass Caution Extreme Lash Mascara, also amazing. If you can get either of these two in the smaller sizes instead of the standard sizes, I'd say get the smaller, especially if you replace your mascara more frequently. So there's a tip. And then you obviously would also not be paying these price tags over here and get the 15% off. So can you tell that I'm talking real fast today? I'm trying to cut my video times down, you guys, because I realize that they can be very long, which is not always convenient to watch. Okay, last two recommendations from Hourglass. The ambient lighting blushes, I think, are one of like the prettiest blushes that you can put on your cheeks. They give you a glow, but they don't drop a ton of shimmer that gets caught in your pores and accentuates the fact that you have enormous pores on your cheeks, like I do. They're just so pretty, you guys. So, so beautiful. And the colors they're just to die for. They don't have a huge selection, but every single one that I've tried, so pretty. Dim Infusion, Mood Exposure, oof, two of my favorites. Absolutely love them. And then lastly, the Hourglass Veil Translucent Setting Powder. I actually forgot to add this into my cart, so I will be buying the full size of this. I loved the mini one that I got so much that I was like seriously bummed when I finished it. This is a beautiful freaking setting powder, you guys. It has that hourglass glow to it, and it's a really hard thing to explain because a lot of times when like YouTube people say glow, they mean that ridiculous like highlight shimmer streak that some people do like on the tops of their cheeks or the tips of their nose or some people all over their face. Like that's not a flattering look for me personally, and so I have to be really careful. But I also don't want my face to look flat, like, you know, no healthy quote unquote glow to it at all. But I have to be careful with where I get my glow. I find that these Hourglass products give me the glow without making me look like a shimmer monster or like I don't know what the heck I'm doing with my makeup. So, yes, these are worth the price point for me. Always, always, I will have these two things in my collection for sure going forward. I want them to come out with some more colors in this blush collection. I don't know that they will. They're kind of, I feel like they're kind of a minimalist brand. Like they just put out the things that are good, and that most people would want, and then they're like, we're gonna cut it off here, which I get. It's expensive to formulate this stuff and all that jazz, but this is what I'm recommending to you guys. These are the things that I love and that I have purchased myself multiple times over in certain cases, and things that I can, in very good conscience, recommend to you. Again, if you are in the market. If you're not in the market, you know, don't buy things that you don't need. I feel like that's something that is not said enough here on YouTube. Buy the things that you need, the things that you really want, but don't go overboard. I don't think that's necessary. So, all right. Thank you guys so much for taking the time to watch today and putting up with my spastic self. I hope you have a great rest of your day, and I will see you guys in my next video. Take care. Bye-bye.